In this video, I will talk about how to solve integer programming problems using the branch and bound method. The branch and bound algorithm is actually an enumeration of candidate solutions in the search space. It splits the original problem into branches of subproblems. Before enumerating the candidate solutions of a branch, the branch is checked against upper or lower estimated bounds of the optimal solution. The branch is discarded if it cannot produce a better solution than the best one found so far by the algorithm. Let's check the branch and bound algorithm for solving maximization integer programming or mixed integer programming problems. A minimization integer programming or mixed integer programming problem can be converted to a maximization problem by maximizing the opposite of the objective function. Step 1 is code initialization. Set z star to be negative infinity. Solve the linear programming relaxation. If not fathomed, then continue. I'll talk about what fathoming is later. Step 2 is code branching. Select the unfathomed subproblem that was created recently. Then choose a branch variable that is supposed to be an integer but is not right now in the optimal solution to the linear programming relaxation of the subproblem. Let xj be this variable and xj star its value in the solution. Create two new subproblems by adding the respective constraints. Xj is less than or equal to the floor function of xj star, and xj is greater than or equal to the ceiling function of xj star. The floor function means the largest integer less than or equal to xj star. The ceiling function means the smallest integer greater than or equal to xj star. Step 3 is called bounding. For each new subproblem, obtain the optimal z value of the linear programming relaxation, which will be the upper bound for this branch of subproblems. Step 4 is called fathoming. Mark the new subproblem as fathomed if at least one of the following three tests is true. Test 1, its z value is less than or equal to z star. Test 2, its linear programming relaxation has no feasible solutions. Test 3, the optimal solution to its linear programming relaxation has integer values for all integer restricted variables. If this test is true, we need to also update z star and retest F1. Step 5 is called the optimality test. We need to stop the algorithm when all the subproblems are fathomed. The current z star is optimal. Otherwise, go to step 2 and repeat the process. Let's check this mixed integer programming example. It is a maximization problem with four variables, x1 through x4. They are all required to be greater than or equal to 0. Only x1, x2, and x3 are required to be integer numbers. The linear programming relaxation is a problem without the integer restrictions. Now let's initialize this star to be negative infinity. Then we solve the linear programming relaxation using the simplex method. The optimal solution is x1 is equal to 1.25, x2 is equal to 1.5, x3 is equal to 1.75, and x4 is equal to 0. The z value is 14.25. This problem is unfathomed because 1. The linear programming relaxation's z value, 14.25, is not less than or equal to z star, negative infinity. 2. The linear programming relaxation is not infeasible. And 3. x1, x2, and x3 are supposed to be integers, but they are not right now. Let's randomly pick one variable that is supposed to be an integer, but it's not now. For example, we pick x1. We call x1 the branch variable. We can split the search space into two parts. One is less than or equal to 1, and the other is greater than or equal to 2. Accordingly, the original problem is split into two subproblems. One is original linear programming relaxation with an additional constraint, x1 is less than or equal to 1. The other is the original linear programming relaxation with an additional constraint, x1 is greater than or equal to 2. Let's solve these two subproblems using the simplex method. We find that this subproblem is infeasible, so it is fathomed based on test 2. The optimum solution to this subproblem is 1, 1.2, 1.8, 0, and the z value is 14.2. This is not fathomed because 14.2 is not less than or equal to the current of this star value. Some integer restricted variables still have fractional numbers. We pick x2 as a branch variable and formulate two subproblems. One is the original linear programming relaxation with two additional constraints. x1 is less than or equal to 1, and x2 is less than or equal to 1. The other is the original linear programming relaxation with two additional constraints. x1 is less than or equal to 1, and x2 is greater than or equal to 2. Let's solve these two subproblems, and these are their optimal solutions. Neither of the two subproblems is fathomed, so we need to continue this process and split it using x1 again for this branch because it is supposed to be an integer, but it's not now. This branch should be x1 is less than or equal to 0, but we know from the problem formulation that x1 should be greater than or equal to 0. So the only possible value in this branch is just x1 is equal to 0. This branch should be x1 is greater than or equal to 1, but we know from a previous step that x1 should be less than or equal to 1. So the only possible value in this branch is just x1 is equal to 1. Let's solve these two subproblems using the simplex method. We find that this subproblem is infeasible, so it is fathomed based on test 2. The optimal solution to this subproblem is 0, 0, 2, 0.5. And the z value is 13.5. This is fathomed based on test 3 because the integer restricted variables x1, x2, and x3 are indeed integer numbers. We also need to update the z star value because it is better than negative infinity. After we update z star, we need to recheck unfathomed subproblems. We find that we only have one unfathomed subproblem, this one. But the upper bound of this branch, 12.17, is worse than the current z-star value, 13.5. So this branch is also fathomed based on test 1. This is the final optimal solution to the mixed integer programming problem. Let's check this binary integer programming example. It is a maximization problem with four variables, x1 through x4. They are all required to be greater than or equal to 0. Also, they are all required to be binary. That means either 0 or 1. The linear programming relaxation is a problem without the binary restrictions. Now let's initialize this star to be negative infinity. Then we solve the linear programming relaxation using the simplex method. This is the optimum solution. The problem is unfathomed. x1 is still not 0 or 1 yet. We call x1 the branch variable and formulate two subproblems. Let's solve these two subproblems using the simplex method. This branch is fathomed because all the variables are binary, so we update z star. This branch is not fathomed yet. We pick x2 as the branch variable and formulate two subproblems. Let's solve these two subproblems and find the optimal solutions. Neither of the two problems is fathomed, so we need to continue this process. For this branch, we split it using x4 and formulate two subproblems. Let's solve these two subproblems. We find that this subproblem is infeasible, so it is fathomed based on test 2. The optimal solution to this subproblem is 1, 1, 0, and 0, and the z value is 14. This is fathomed based on test 3, because binary restricted variables x1 through x4 are all 0 or 1. We update z star value because 14 is better than 9. After we update z star, we need to recheck unfathomed subproblems. We find that we only have one unfathomed subproblem, this one. But the upper bound of this branch, 13, is worse than the current z value of 14. So this branch is also fathomed based on test 1. This is the final optimal solution to the binary integer programming problem. Okay, that's how to use branch and bound to solve integer programming, mixed integer programming, and binary integer programming problems. Thanks for watching.